Hello, lovely dancers. My name is Aisha and welcome back to Belly Dance Tutorials. In today's class, I'm gonna go over some belly accents. In this video, I'm gonna continue with the belly work that I started last time, I think. And I want to go over some of the belly accents that we use in belly dance. So, let's start with the belly out and then we'll do belly in. Before I start, like with any abdominal work, these accents involve a state of relaxation and a state of contraction. So before you get into the contraction, you'll have to have your abdominal wall relaxed. And it's pretty hard to get a hang of it, to go from one state into the other, especially that we keep our core a lot of time contracted when we dance. But, you know, it's something that we can work on. So let's go with a belly pop out. It's gonna be like out. Now, to get a relaxation in the abdominal wall, you'll need to have your knees bent, pelvis a little bit tucked in, and really let the abdominal, the stomach hanging out. And when we do the accents, we pull in a little bit, but then we go out and in, out and in, out and in. So it's a touch and go. I call this touch and go. Pop, pop, yep. Yeah. So again, we start with a little contraction here, but then the accent is on the out, 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 out. This usually happens on accents in the music, yeah, on the drum accents. Sometimes on dooms, sometimes on tex, but most of the time dooms. So when you're going out, is a bigger movement, has more expansion in it, and I think dooms are better for this movement. And it's not much else to say other than practice it and make it strong, accentuated, popping, which means that you really have to train your abs for that. Now let's go over the accents in, which for me are easier. Because you go in a more contracted state, yeah? From a little out here, we're gonna go in, 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 in. And you're trying to bring this part, the middle part of the abdominal wall, inside, in. And then try to not bring the ribcage downward, so it's not this, yeah? So you're not going in like that, yeah? It's not a drop. It could be in some situations, but not for now. It's rather a pelvic rotation in. So it's, you're involving the pelvis to go, to bring this part of the abdomen in, and you keep your upper body upright and the chest even a little forward, yeah? In, 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 yeah? So the upper body stays in place, you relax first, and then you bring everything in, helping with the pelvic bones a little bit. Let's try the other. It doesn't matter which leg is forward. And you can help yourself with the breathing. Another way of doing the inward accents is to use the diaphragm and to create the abdominal vacuum that we use for belly flutter and for other things. This is a much deeper inward movement and it involves mostly the upper part. So when you create abdominal vacuum, and I cannot talk when I do that because I close my throat, yeah. And then when you release and contract, you get this strong accent in. I have to breathe first. So you inhale, exhale. Yeah, let's try other way. It helps when you prepare this movement. Yeah, it's very hard to get into this movement without preparation. So you want to prepare it. So you exhale, inhale, and lift the ribcage up. Yeah. So that's another way of doing the accent in. One more I could talk about. It's an accent in on the lower part of the abdomen, and it's a sharp. But it starts with roll out, so there is a little preparation before you get this lower part in. It starts with a little roll out, yeah. So it's an undulation, a reverse undulation, but only on the on the lower part of the body, of the abdomen. Yeah, so it starts like that. But once you get out, you pull in sharply and quickly. So there is a little tuck, 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 tuck. That's good for accents on pecs. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, dancers, I hope you like my quick class on belly accents. Thank you for watching, and please give it a thumbs up if you liked it. If you have any comments or suggestions, write them down in the comments box and I'll try to address them if I can. I hope to see you next time with more tutorials like this. Until then, shimmy shimmy!